Hi, this is Gary with MACMOST.com. Here are some tips for getting the most out of the alerts in the calendar app on your Mac. So when you create an event in the calendar app, you may get an alert, say 15 minutes before the event, but you can customize those events so they appear at different times or at the exact time of the event, and even have multiple alerts for a single event. So when you create a new event in the calendar, you have the opportunity to set an alert. There's probably one set by default for each event. This will give you a notification on your Mac and across your Apple devices if you're using iCloud, so you know when the event is happening or about to happen. But there are a lot of different ways to modify these alerts to fit your needs. So I'm going to double click here in the monthly view on the calendar to just quickly create an event. And I get this little window here where I could set up the event. I could give it a name and then set the date and time. It's already going to have the date from wherever it is I clicked, but I can modify the time. Say, let's have this be 11 a.m. for instance. Now, when you go into this area here by clicking to modify the time, you'll also see the ability to modify the alert. Now, what you're going to see here is a default. For instance, it may say 15 minutes before the event. But you don't have to settle for the default. If you want to get the alert at the exact time of the event, you don't need any advance warning of this. You can just change it to at time of event. So if the entire purpose of the event is to remind you of something at 11 a.m. on this day, you don't have to set it for 11:15 a.m. just to get the alert to be at the proper time. Now, if this is an event you have to travel to, you may want it to alert you a certain number of minutes beforehand so you can get there on time. So another option here is instead of at the time of the event, you can go up here to travel time and set that for some amount. So say if it's going to take 15 minutes, or maybe we'll go to custom and say it's going to take 20 minutes to get there. If I set that up, then this changes to at start of travel time. So if you had it set to 15 minutes before, you would go up to at start of travel time, and now it's going to alert you 20 minutes before. If you think you need to adjust that later, just adjust the travel time and the alert will happen at the appropriate time. Now, another way to do that is to actually enter a location for the event. So I'm going to type a sample location near me, just type a little bit of the address and pick out the place from the list. And then when you set the time here, you could set the alert for time to leave. What this will do is it will look at the location, figure out things like traffic, and give you an alert telling you this event, say 22 minutes away, it might be time to leave. This is very useful if you're setting the calendar event on your Mac, and then when it actually happens, you're not even where your Mac is. You're somewhere else with your iPhone. You get the alert for the appropriate amount of time it takes to get there. Now, when you create a new event, it may automatically give you an alert 15 minutes ahead of time or at the time of the event, or maybe no alert at all and you always have to manually set the alert. You can change the default. If you go to calendar settings and then go to alerts here at the top. Now, it's very important to select the account here. I just have calendars that are on my Mac, local only, and iCloud, but you may also have other calendars like ones in Google. So choose the account first. Then choose the default alert time. So 15 minutes before, at the time of the event, none, and so on. For all day events, events that just have a date and no time, you could also set a default here. You could set whether or not these are only for this computer and you would use other defaults, say on your iPhone. You also could turn this option on, which will give you time to leave alerts even if you haven't set them up for that event. Now, you may have noticed when I created an event and set a location for it, I got two different alerts. You can create as many alerts as you want just by using the plus button here. So I've got this 15 minutes before one. Let's set that to 10 minutes before. But I also want it to remind me about this event the day before. So I'll click plus here and I'll create an alert for one day before. And you can continue to click plus and create more alerts if you need them. You can also set these for any amount of time. You don't have to go with these default intervals. Just go to custom here and then set a number of minutes, like say 20 minutes, but you could also do hours or days before. If you find these videos valuable, consider joining the more than 2,000 others that support MACMOST through Patreon. You get exclusive content, course discounts, and more. You can read about it at MACMOST.com/Patreon. You could also set them for a specific time. So choose from this list on date, and then you could set a date. So I'll have it be a couple days before, and then I'll have it be at a specific time on that day. So this is no longer related to the time of the event. The event can move to 3 days later, and I'll still get this alert at this time. Also notice another option under custom is for after the event starts. So minutes, hours, or days after. So you can have an alert that's a reminder, say, to follow up from things from that meeting, or perhaps maybe if it's something where it's an online meeting and you don't need to be there at the very beginning of it, you could have the event be the real time for the meeting, but only alert you 15 minutes after it starts. Now, another kind of custom alert, and one that I use all the time, is to have an email message sent. Now, you can only choose one of your email addresses. This is for sending an alert to you, not to somebody else. They would have to set that up in their calendar, or if you just want to set up your Mac to send an email at a future time, that's something you do in the Mail app. But here, you can have your calendar app send an alert to you as an email message a certain amount of time before, after, or on a specific date, and then you get that in your email inbox. For me, that's really useful as somebody that always pays very close attention to the inbox to be able to, say, have an alert for an important event a couple hours before the event in with my other important email that's still in my inbox. Another thing you could do under custom is set it to open a file. The default here is calendar. So you could just have it open up the calendar app instead of sending an alert, or have it as a second alert in addition to a notification. Or you can have it set to open up a specific file. For instance, maybe a spreadsheet file if the event involves adding data to a spreadsheet. Just select other and then just choose any file you like. Now you can use that to have it play a custom sound for you. So go into the Shortcuts app and create a shortcut, a really simple one. The first action is just file, and then you can choose the file for some sort of sound file you have on your Mac. And then the second action is just play sound to play the sound from that file. So now you want to go to file and then add to dock. When you do, it adds to the dock, but then you could just remove it from the dock. You can now run this using the calendar. Just select open file, choose other, and then go to your home folder, applications, select it there, and now it will open that little app that just plays that sound. But you could also use the speak text action here to just put some text and have a Siri-like voice read the text to you. Now, an alternative to creating an event in the calendar is to simply create a reminder. So just go to the Reminders app, and in any list you like the main one here, just create a new reminder and then click on Add Date, set a specific date. You can choose a custom date if you want. And then once you have a date set, you could set a specific time. Just type the time in there, and then this will give you a notification. You can modify it here later on if you want, even have it notify you early, just like the calendar does. It's always a bit of a dilemma trying to figure out if something belongs as a reminder in the Reminders app or as an event in the calendar app. In general, if something involves more than one person or going to a location, then that's probably an event in the calendar app. If something just involves you wanting to get a notification to do something or remember something at a specific time, then that probably belongs as a reminder in the Reminders app. But there's a lot of gray area in between, and sometimes there's no right answer. You could do either one, whichever you like. Now, really cool option we've got starting with macOS Tahoe is that you can go into the calendar app and see those reminders here in the calendar app. So here's that one I just created. You need to have the scheduled reminders item here in the left sidebar under other checked, and then you'll see these appear in the calendar. As a matter of fact, you can even double click and edit them here in the calendar, or when you click the plus button or use file, then new, you can create a new reminder here in the calendar app. So if you like the calendar app better than reminders, you can do it all here, but have the actual item stored as a reminder instead of as an event. And you can even complete items here in the calendar by clicking on the little circle next to it. Plus, under View, you have a checkbox next to Show Completed Reminders. So if you turn that off, when a reminder is completed, it will disappear from your calendar, so it doesn't get too cluttered. Another option is to use the Clock app and set an alarm. So an alarm has a couple of advantages over an event or a reminder. One is that it will be an alert that keeps going, like an alarm should, to make sure you don't miss it. But you can also choose snooze and use a snooze function here, which could be useful. You can kind of schedule alarms a couple days out by using the set of repeat buttons here. For instance, if it's Monday, you could have an alarm that only is going to go off on Thursday at a specific time. And then when it does go off, just remember to delete or turn off the alarm so it doesn't happen again the next Thursday. You can also label alarms here with a message so you can remember what it is you're supposed to be doing at this time. And speaking of repeating things, you can repeat events in the calendar as well. So for this event here, you could set repeat to, say, every day, every week, every month on this day, and every year on this day, if you like. But you could customize it even more. So you could have it be weekly, but say on multiple days, like every Monday, Wednesday, and Friday. You could also have it be monthly and have it be on a certain day every month. You can do every other month if you want. You could have it be on the first, second, third, next to last, and all that day, weekday. You have tons of different options here. And you could further customize once you've set up the repeat. For instance, I'll have this be every week. So it's going to be every Monday. But if I already know it's not going to be happening this Monday, I can select it and then press delete and say only this event. So now it'll skip that day. Furthermore, I can go later and say, well, this is the last time it's going to happen. So I can select the next one, delete, and say delete all future events. So now I've got this repeating event that's just going to happen these 6 times. This is still just one event. I can go to the first one and delete it and delete all, and it takes them all away. And one last thing, also remember to check in System Settings and then under Notifications to make sure that the notifications for the calendar app are turned on and set up as you like. So as you can see, there's lots of different ways to customize and get more out of alerts in the calendar app. Hope you found this useful. Thanks for watching. If you liked this video, click the thumbs up button below to let me know. I publish new tutorials each weekday. Hit the subscribe button so you don't miss out.